Final Cut Pro 11 is here, and the brand new magnetic mask feature is amazing. It allows you to do some really cool effects effortlessly. So I wanted to give you a quick little tutorial of how to simply put text behind a subject rather than just in front of them. This has always been possible in Final Cut Pro. It just takes a lot more time. Now it's as easy as ever. So let's dive right into Final Cut Pro so I can show you just how easy it is to apply this mask and show you some of the things that you can actually do in it. So let's say I have a clip like this and I want to do something to it. Maybe I want to change the background and almost make it like it's a green screen, or maybe I want to change and put some text behind me while I'm talking in this clip. All you have to do is simply take the magnetic mask found here in the mask and keying. You can see that there's a new magnetic mask plugin, and you can simply just drag it right over top of the clip. And as you're dragging it over top of the clip, it's basically trying to predict what it thinks you want to magnetize it to. So you can see that as I click kind of right in the dead middle of me here on this subject, you'll see that it will just right away highlight around, no drawing the mask around. And all you have to do is go ahead and hit analyze. And this is real time happening right in front of you. You can see how fast this actually does it, but it's basically analyzing me and analyzing all the movement in the shot to determine the tracking that it needs to do. And then it will go the opposite direction and it will do the entire clip from where you're at here. And then what's really neat is I just go ahead and hit done. You can see that it now has masked me out really, really well. Now, obviously I'm not looking for it to be a black background, but what's cool here is I could duplicate this clip if I want. And you'll see that now if I turn the mask off of that one. Now this top clip here has the mask, this bottom one does not. So maybe I want to put some sort of effect over top of that actual clip to be able to do something unique with it. Maybe for some reason I wanted to do like a comic look on myself, and not saying this is what you'd want to do, but all I got to do now is drag this to the top mask, and you'll see that it will now just make that top mask only perfectly blended in.
It's incredible.
It tracks just me inside that. Now, obviously that looks terrible, but maybe I'd want to do something more with actual color. Maybe you wanted to take a clip and for some reason you wanted to make it black and white. I can make me black and white on the front there. Maybe I could do the opposite if I wanted to put black and white in the background. Whatever it is, you can see that it's just very simple to simply drag something on top of there. Now, what I like the most for it is actually being able to put text behind a subject is a really cool feature. And you could always do this in Final Cut, but it took a lot longer. And now check this out. Let's say I really liked this specific video clip. Now, obviously, you see that if I set it like this, it will put that intro. Let's just rename this so it says magnetic test. Now, you can see that if it's above the clip here, nothing happens. But if I simply now drag it between these two clips, you'll see that now, boom, just like that, it's behind me. And look at how good it has masked around me. You can see that it's actually seeing the letters behind my glasses, which is just amazing how good that tracking is with no work whatsoever. Just look at this.
Man-made lake, and it's incredible.
Perfectly around my neck, through my glasses. Awesome. Awesome. You could also do that with any text. So no matter what you chose, if you chose something that you specifically liked the look of, or if you just put a regular text on here, make this as big as you want, obviously. Put it right between here. Maybe you want to keyframe this for some reason because you actually want it to move throughout the clip and move entirely behind me. I could do that. I could just create my quick keyframes and I can make it go to here. And then you can see just like that.
Man-made lake. And it's incredible. Like it just goes forever.
And what's impressive about this is it doesn't even matter how much is actually happening in the frame. If I simply take one that like this that has obviously a little bit more going on in the frame and me moving around and actually my phone being put in front of me while I'm talking, I can still just throw that magnetic mask on there. I can still analyze this and you'll see just how quick it still has no problem. I can go ahead and hit done. And you can see that now it's obviously has me perfectly masked. If I wanted to duplicate this again like I did last time, take this clip underneath and turn off the magnetic mask so that it's back around me. Sometimes we'll do some of these little sidebars here that allow us to do some more of maybe more of a corporate video. Maybe I wanted to have the sidebar come in but instead of it coming in and pushing me aside like this clip typically does, where it'll come in, if this mask was not here, you'd see that when the clip comes in, it pushes me aside and then goes like that, which I don't really love the look of. Well, I can take that exact preset, and now that it's behind me, you can see that I can do some really cool things with it, because maybe I wanted to make it slide in, but I wanted to look a little bit more professional. Check this out now. That looks really clean there behind me, rather than before where it would go like this and kind of come over top of me. And obviously I don't like the look of that, but simply by throwing that mask on there, boom, it now puts it behind there, and a very, very clean, very, very clean look. Like, look how nice that looks around there. Awesome. Now, there may be times that you actually get a mask that maybe is a little bit off. So for example, you can see in this, if you look really closely, it's not masking around my neck because it thinks that's, you know, maybe something that it shouldn't be masking. You can actually go ahead here and click the little brush minus, and you'll see that if you just kind of minus around that thing, it'll just fix that. I can obviously choose the feather here to just get it closer, but if there are any specific areas that have trouble, you can just go to them and remove the brush, or you can do the opposite and click add brush. And if you just wanted to add more things into the mask for some reason, you can do that as well. You could just add a whole little section, and you can see that it now does that. And once you do that, it still will track after the fact. So it's as simple as that now in Final Cut 11 to be able to create a mask, have it track and do all the work for you and create some really cool effects with that no more drawing mask or having to have third-party plugins, all that stuff. It just works awesome. Final Cut Pro 11 has a lot of new features. We'll dive into some more of them in some upcoming videos. But in this one, I just want to quickly point out what that magnetic mask will allow you to do. I think you'll have a lot of fun with it. So play around, let me know what you think, and comment below if there's anything additional you want to learn. Thanks for watching.